present to you Dr. D.B. Dingle, a man who really needs no introduction. Dr. Dingle will speak today on a topic of great importance, fiscal responsibility in a capitalistic society. Dr. Dingle.
Class of 1987, Bentley and Prentice. Theoretically speaking, the financial mobility of an individual in today's capitalist society is more dependent on...
Boring. This man is boring. I can't believe I spent the whole last year just waiting to be sitting here. This is so boring.
Boring, 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 boring.
English. It's just like English. We read the works of Twain and Hemingway and Hamlet in that Shakespeare play. You know the one about the son who killed the king, who killed his dad because he knew he was the cat with whom his mom was.
Boring! It was so boring!
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 Sex education! It's overcome at all what I expected.
The whole school's laughing. And me, I failed sex education. I'll never get it in again.
I totally got rid of my acne, and like I totally learned how to use makeup. I even stopped going taller than all the guys. I was like positive all the trauma was like over, okay? Well then Dr. Schwarzenbach has the nerve to tell me that I have to get braces. I am so sure. The little metal thing. The little shiny, ugly, gapey, wiry metal thing. Make my lips stick out before me for the railroad tracks beneath. Not to mention all the kissing, I just knew that I'd be missing. Cause who wants to kiss the girl who picked up radar with her teeth? I remember the junior prom. My date was Brad and I was stoked. He was Brad.
My days of being lonely were finally through. My 1957 Pontiac convertible. I love her sweet things, tell me what's fine. I love her sunshine rain. She's the lady of my life. My life can be the same. She is sleek and she is sassy. From her headlight to her chest. She's cherry, she's prime. I think of her all of the time. She's my lady, she's my lady. My lady, and she's driving me wild. Oh yeah.
I'm the girl in the back row who never raised her hand. I'm the girl at all the dances who wasn't in demand. I'm the girl. Girl, you sat beside whose name you
I packed his class. Well, on the last day of class, when all the graded papers were passed out, guess what? I got a C, a passing grade! I freaked him that I was going to graduate. Boy, I wonder what he's thinking right now. And he would feel like a total jerk if I finally passed his class. Wait a minute. As I sit here asking questions, how I move the same old tune. Somehow I have come to suspect that he would be wanting me.
Cheers of the crowd at the homecoming game. The glory of carrying the ball into the end zone. To get the phone number of all the cheerleaders. Well, the week before the biggest game of my senior year, I broke my right leg. Well, I had spent a couple years in the high school band. So Mr. Wong, the band teacher, told me I could stand in and play my trombone on the sidelines during the game. The mood was tense. The score was tied. Seconds left to go. All at once, the underside intercepts our throw. Wow, wow, team once, a mighty force, helpless as could be. On they ran, the other side, towards a victory. I threw my trombone on the field. Well, at the time, I thought it was brilliant strategy. But the guy did three somersaults when he tripped on my trombone. He backed two teeth out, and he bent my trombone like in half. Well, the whole stadium became an angry mob, angry at me. Everyone was shouting. Mr. Wong told me I'd have to pay for the trombone. Coach Pratt told me he'd never want to see me again, and he made me turn in my jersey. The refs gave the other team the touchdown. Well, looking back, you'd think one good thing would have come out of this. Nothing. Well, at home, they still laugh and ask, "Hey, Martinelli, are you still playing the trombone?" I should have played the piccolo.
Vividly.
My family had just moved in. I'm an army brat, but I didn't know a soul. It was horrible. Nobody would talk to me.
I am!
Except for the boys. Then I met Dominic. At first I thought he was like all the other boys. Later I realized he wasn't at all. He was worse. But of course to know Dominic is to love him. It's weird to think we've been friends for almost 4 years. Well, I remember the first time I ever saw Dominic.
I remember the first time I saw Dina. Well, it was the first week of school and she was sitting all by herself on this bench. And I thought to myself, she had to be a sophomore or a junior. Because by that time I had met all the freshman girls. Anyway, I remember I went up to Dean and I said, my name's Dominic!
Drop dead.
And we really hit it off! I mean, not like boyfriend and girlfriend, but just friend-friend, which was kind of weird because I never had a girl who was just a friend before. Well, except for my mom, but that doesn't count. So anyway, Dean and I, we started doing everything together, and we always got into trouble. Well, I remember this one time in biology. We used to sit behind this girl, who was always really quiet. Well, except when Mr. Jennings would call on her, and then she'd always give the right answer. I hate that. Anyway, Dean and I, we decided to play a trick. So one day, we crept up behind her.
They crept up behind me and whispered right into my ear, look under the chair. And right there, next to my feet, was this huge bullfrog, warts and all. So I did what any mature young lady would do. Then I started to cry. Well, Dominic and Dina got put on detention for a month. I felt really bad. So I put some cookies up to the detention room for them. Even though they were pulling a trick on me, I felt kind of honored that I was the one they chose. And Dominic liked my cookies so much, he invited me to lunch with him and Dina. And the next day, we were in the cafeteria where Dina sees this kid eating something really strange. So she just goes up and
asks me what I'm eating. Well, I tell her sushi. Now, when I explain to the three of them that sushi's raw fish, they all made these weird faces. And then Dominic asks me,
are you like God, Japanese?
Well, as a matter of fact, I am part Japanese, Chinese, Mexican, and Irish, to which Dina replies,
I think Oriental and Hispanic Irish men are so sexy.
I admit it. I was in love. Well, anyway, the four of us went out that weekend to see a movie. I don't quite remember which one. But as usual, Leslie just sat there the whole time crying. And when we all ran out of Kleenex, Leslie just sat there dripping. It was not until she heard someone appear on his back blowing his nose. So Leslie, like a shot, was running up the aisle and asked
me if I could spare a tissue. So I said, sure. And then afterwards, Dominic comes up to me and he said,
hey, were you the guy who kept sobbing so loud?
And I nodded my head, yeah. And Dominic started laughing at me. Well, I told him that I didn't see what was so funny, but he kept laughing. So I took my popcorn and I dumped it on him. And Dominic stopped laughing. And I thought to myself, jumping jelly beans, what have I done? This guy is gonna kill me. And then, all of a sudden, Dominic started laughing. And then they all started laughing. And they invited me out to McGee's ice cream parlor afterwards. We've been together ever since. You know, it's kind of funny. But to look at the five of us, well, you would never think that we were the very best of friends. We're five of a kind, and always together.
Our lives are entwined.
For now and forever.
For other someone's we can lean on
when troubled times descend.
Nothing can steer us wrong
as long as we're friends. Friends, no fighter we found that's obvious to us.
Friends,
we're blissfully bound. No one can undo us.
What matter if the world is rocky? We'll find the rainbow's end.
Spring, summer, winter, fall,
we will always be friends. Well, it was my idea to go around the world. I had been reading that book by Jules Verne, and it made me think, hey, that sounds like a lot of fun. So I went and asked Dina to see what she thought.
always intrigued me.
So we went to our parents with the idea of going around the world. I remember their reaction to the idea very clearly.
No! That's what they said. They said we can't afford it and we were much too young. So we said, if not now, when? When are we going to get another chance like this? Besides, we knew we could come up with the money somehow. Well, we of course have different methods of securing the necessary capital.
Daddy, Dee Dee doesn't want a car for graduation. Dee Dee wants a trip.
I know, I usually make deposits, but this time I'm making a withdrawal.
I'd like 25 lottery tickets, please.
Dear Grandma, do you know how much I love you?
Hi, my name is John Paul, and this is your singing telegram.
Well, when our parents finally realized we were very serious about going,
they said yes!
Around the world at 80, magical fun and wonderful day. We'll find a river waiting when we're done in wonderful ways.
Follow your budget, buying nothing but only the essential. I mean that.
We'll search on you all night.
We are only a phone call away.
A trail will lay.
What do you do, Charlie? Please don't forget to write to your grandma.
We're traveling to our traveling to our hit the road. There's no time to lose. The world.